Now, myotome is basically the group of the muscle that a single nerve supply. So here again, as we have multiple nerves that are being supplying different group muscles, the muscles that are present at the different regions of the body. Again, we'll be studying here in detail about, as we started about the dermatomes definition, the detail of dermatomes, the mapping, the chart, and each and every detail. So we'll be studying about the definitions of myotomes, we'll be studying about the, because they have to be supplying muscles, so here we'll be studying about the skeletal muscle fibers in detail. We'll be studying here about the function and the clinical significance, why this learning is really important, especially this myotome, to learn this these myotomes and dermatomes really important. Again, definition is, a myotome is basically a group of muscle that a single spinal nerve innervates. In vertebrae's embryonic development, myotome is a part of somite that develops into a muscle. So it's just, you know, it's a history, it's all the way along back when you are an embryo or you were inside the fetus, you were a fetus in your mother's womb. So, you know, that is like from somite, these myotomes are being originating and supplying then different groups of the muscle. So, okay, here is the diagrammatic appearance. Let me give you a brief detail about all these myotomes in this section, in this slide. So here we have the cervical region from which the cervical nerves are originating, and this one is the thoracic region. Then we have lumbar region. So we'll be a bit of just going through that how they have to be supplying your multiple group of the muscles. So here the cervical region, from we have C3 to C5. Myotome or C3 to C5 nerves that have to be supplying your diaphragm. So that means they're helping you out in breathing during inhalation and during exhalation of the air. C5 goes to the biceps. So bicep bends, that means elbow bend. C6 is for deltoid muscle. It's for extensor carpi, bends wrist backward. So we have to be bending our wrist at backward. So backward wrist bending. Tricep, C7 is to tricep strengthening the elbows. So that means straightening the elbows. So when we straight up, when we straight up our elbows, first we bend our elbows and then we straighten up. Then we straighten up our elbows, that means that is C7 nerve is performing this function. C8 for the palmar intrachii, this says that bend your fingers. When we bend our fingers, that means C8 intrachii for the palmar intrachii muscles. Then we have T1 for the dorsal intrachii to spread the fingers. So from the start of T1 nerve, it says just spread your fingers for the abduction of the fingers. T1 to T12 is the muscles of chest and abdomen. So again, that arrangement, you see that here is again, as the arrangement of the dermatomes, there's a same or specific arrangement for the myotomes. So T1 to T12 is supplying the muscles of the chest and abdomen. Now we have the L2. L2 is to iliopsoas to bend your hips, or you know, the flex your hips, like I'm sitting position. So that means I'm bending my hips. Now L3 is the quadricep femoris, strengthening your knees. So just straighten up your knee. Whenever you're just sitting position, just straighten up your knees. I can just demonstrate it here in front of you guys, but I can tell you here to just straighten up your knees, or just whenever you just try to kick someone out during sitting position. So that's, you know, a funny position, but still you do it. Now L4 is the anterior tibialis to pull your feet up. If that's your feet, you have to pulling your feet up in the dorsiflexion position. L5 is for extensor digiti muscles to just extend your to the fingers of the toes of the foot. Now, myotomes are skeletal muscle fibers. So the skeletal muscle fibers are being innervated by somatic motor fibers of several spinal nerves. So every skeletal muscle is being innervated by somatic motor fibers of several spinal nerves. So the muscle myotome will consist of several segments. So we have a muscle myotome. We have a segment of a muscle. And that segment of the muscle has further multiple segments. You know, that's really interesting thing. We have a muscle present here and we can divide it in multiple segments. And in that segments, different nerves are being innervating and just supplying that muscle. Muscle myotomes have been grouped by joint movements to facilitate the clinical testing. Okay, now here we have this have been grouped by joined, because joints are really, really important performing your activities, daily life activities. They have to be facilitating you in clinical testing. The intrinsic muscles of hand constitute a single myotome, which is T1. So intrinsic muscle of hand constitute a single myotome, which is T1. Now, clinical significance include, we have to give you the information about the level in the spine, where a lesion may be present. So, you know, it gives you an idea that if that nerve is supplying some specific muscle and that muscle is not working properly, that I've told you that to perform some movements, to do these movements, if there any lesion is present, so I'll get information that this area is not working properly, that the nerve supply is not well here. So, for example, C2 has to do to bend your neck. If that bending is not possible or not present, so that means there is some issue or some problem is being there. And from C2 is to just touch your, you know, like ears to your shoulders. C3 is like this, and C4 is for shrugging, and then C5 is the, I've told you in the previous picture as well. So all these, we just ask the patient to perform all these activities. When the patient is unable to do that, that means that his lesion is present or the muscle is weak. If the muscle is weak, or, you know, you can say that the nerve, that a single nerve that's supplying that region is not working properly. Now, results may indicate lesions to the spinal cord, nerve root, or intervertebral disc herniation pressing on the spinal nerve roots. Now, when we just conclude to the results, when we just see that if there are any lesions, that is an indication that these lesions to spinal cord nerve roots or intervertebral, there may be intervertebral nerve, intervertebral disc herniation is present, these vertebrae are being pressed together, or disc has been protruded out, or there's a painful condition, or the nerves are being compressed or not supplying that region properly to that specific part in detail, are pressing on the spinal nerve roots. Now we have functions of the myotome. So myotome again relates to the muscle group. So this is your bicep muscle and the tricep muscle, which shows your flexion and extension movements. As I've told you, you can just ask your patient to flex your elbow to see that if the myotome that is supplying this region is working properly or not. So just ask your patient to extend your elbow to see that if muscle has its proper functioning or not. Each muscle in the body is supplied by one or more levels of segments of the spinal cord and by their corresponding spinal nerves. Now, a group of muscles innervated by motor fibers of the single nerve root is known as a myotome. That is a very simple thing, that there's a group of muscles that are being innervated by motor fibers of the single spinal nerve root. So in the dermatomes, we studied that there's a sensory nerve root there. So sensory root is supplying the dermatome region, whereas here we have the motor pattern, because we ask the patient to perform some activities to do the specific actions, like to ask the patient to flex your arm. So if the motor part of that nerve root is not working properly, so how can the patient be able to just extend or just flex the elbow, extend the elbow, or to perform some specific activity? So that means that myotomes have some problems, or that nerve has some innervation problem. Again, we have this myotomes, which I've showed you, that this lateral rotation of the shoulder is to C5, medial rotation of the arm goes for C6, C7, C8, finger goes from flexion, finger flexion. When we do this finger flexion, that means C8, C7, that means C7 is properly functioning in here, C7 and C8 are properly functioning here. The adduction of the shoulder. So abduction, you see that to just bring that specific segment towards the body means adduction, adding. And then away from the body, that means abduction. So here abduction is performed by C5, and C6, C7 again is being performed by the these myotomes. We have this medial internal rotation of the hip occurs because of L4, L5, and L5, S1 is the lateral external rotation. This is the same thing explaining you here. This is the lateral, again, the lateral, you can see the lateral rotation of the hip towards the lateral side. If you just move it, because of L5 and S1 myotomes, medial rotation is to L4 and L5 myotomes. The adduction and adduction of hip is again because of the L5, S1, and L2, L3, and L4. Now we have this extension of the hip is because of L4 and L5 myotomes, and hip flexion is because of L2 and L3. So L2 and L3 is for hip flexion, and then hip extension is because L4 and L5. S1 and S2 is going to be performing your plantar flexion, and dorsiflexion is performed by L4 and L5. So these are, we'll be studying the myotomes of the whole body in detail. But this is just a general information, just to tell you that these are the myotomes, these are the motor nerve root fibers that are being supplied these specific muscles of the body and performing specific actions. Again, here if you see this abduction and adduction of the hands, when we do this abduction away from the body, that is T1 action. Adduction is not merely being performed by some specific nerve. That is, you know, that's a normal phenomenon that our arms, our fingers are being in adducted position. But to abduct the fingers, we need a T1 nerve to perform that action. So this was about section 3, where we've started in detail about the myotomes. I hope it is really clear to you now. Thank you for watching sqadia.com.